Before the bomb unleashed its fearsome power, it took 3 years to develop at a cost of $2 billion. It was beneath the canyons of Manhattan that the A-bomb found its roots in at least 10 locations, including warehouses that stored uranium. Columbia University was the epicenter, where 700 people were engaged in early experiments on how to split the atom. But it was along Lower Broadway's Canyon of Heroes that the atomic bomb took its first steps. Here at 25 Broadway, officers of a mining company arranged for the mining of 1,200 tons of high-grade uranium ore.
At the iconic Woolworth Building, a front company occupied three floors and employed 4,000 people who focused on ways to harness uranium's rare isotopes. And the building that now houses the famed Friars Club is purported to have been one of the sites of Manhattan Project meetings. It was then occupied by a physics group. And Albert Einstein is said to have walked those hallowed halls.
Members of the American Institute of Physics, who owned the building from 1943 to 1957, told me that there were several meetings between Albert Einstein and Robert Oppenheimer in this building.
On August 6, 1945, a lone bomb was dropped over Hiroshima, killing 140,000 people. 96-year-old Army veteran Danny Massey of Westchester was en route to join troops in the Pacific, delighted that a weapon had ended the war. But looking back on it today, he hopes it will never be used again.
And another war of any kind today would be devastating. It'd be worse than the atomic bomb. They have to stay away from atomic bombs except for the use of atomic energy.
One of the survivors of the Hiroshima bombing is this bronze statue of a 12th century Japanese monk. Found just a short distance from the epicenter of the explosion, it was recovered and brought to New York in 1955, where it sits in front of a Buddhist church on Riverside Drive. A plaque calls the statue a testament to the bomb's devastation.
As well as a symbol for lasting hope for world peace, the same message that echoed around the world on this, the 75th anniversary of the bombing of Hiroshima. Reporting from home, I'm Marvin Scott, PIX 11 News.